Good morning, everyone. So I just wanted to give a bit of clap out, really, and a big thank you to everyone that's keeping this country standing at the moment. It's a huge list. There's lots of people, isn't it? So you think about it, and everyone's supposed to be in lockdown, but you realise quite how many people are out there risking it for us every day. So fair play to you. Thank you. Hopefully if you hear the eye of the tiger in the background, I thought it was quite apt. We seem to be in a bit of a scrap at the moment, but I reckon we'll come out of it all right. So, So I'd like to say thank you to all the hospital staff, doctors, nurses, cleaners, ambulance drivers, the caterers, the porters, receptionists, the mechanics that are keeping all the vehicles going for them, and everyone that's involved in running a hospital. It's a huge amount of people. So thank you very much. We know you're pushing yourself to the limits. We appreciate it. We really, really do. Care workers who got kind of missed at the beginning of all this. I've worked in care homes myself, and it's a tough job at the best of times. So under these circumstances, it's a real push. So fair play to you for knocking out the hours. It's amazing. Hospice staff, tough job. Tough job at the best of times, but you know, they keep going in and they keep pushing it and supporting our family and friends and stuff all the way through it. So thank you. You've got bin men, shop workers, lorry drivers, the firemen, the police, GP doctors and staff and receptionists, pharmacists. You know, these are people that, you know, you don't really give a second thought most of the time, because, you know, like everyone else, they're just ticking along doing their job, like, you know, the majority of us each day. The mental health charities, the community projects that have, and counsellors that have had to adapt the way they work over the last couple of months to ensure that, you know, some of the most vulnerable people in our society are still cared for. Thank you very much. The volunteers, I've signed up for a couple of volunteer things and they've had so many volunteers they don't need them. I mean, that's amazing. Whoever volunteers in normal life, not many people, but when called upon, people are standing up to it, so thank you. Family, friends and neighbours who are, you know, sending that odd text, talking to a neighbour over the fence, just making sure everybody's okay. These are things that weren't happening before, do you know what I mean? So our community's growing because of it. And everyone who's sticking to the guidelines that are put in place for a reason, even though everyone's missing people, it's so important, so thank you. So I know that list isn't exhaustive, because there's many, many more people out there, so if I've missed you, you're included in it too. So yeah, just a huge, huge thank you, not just for me, Karen, everyone who isn't a key worker, who isn't out there, who is stuck in the house. We appreciate it, because we do know the country would crumble without you. One last note, all these Facebook thingies about how people all of a sudden realising who's important in the country, who keeps our country running. It's not the sports stars or the politicians or the movie stars or the, you know, the full celebrities. You know, the core of our country are the people on the lower wages, unfortunately, that do the grinding work. Yeah, the country would fall apart without us. And hopefully people will remember that when we go back to said norm. Hopefully we'll learn some lessons and we'll keep them going, and we'll appreciate the people around us who are doing tough, tough jobs day in, day out. So thank you, everyone. Again, we really, really appreciate it. You're all superstars. Keep going, keep smiling and keep safe. Thank you.